dogs out?
Protect dogs is actually protecting the abusers.
It is legal to keep hundreds of dogs with no staff. There is no dog-to-staff ratio on puppy farms. It is legal to breed a dog for its entire life until its body can no longer cope. There is no maximum litter number in the code of practice. It is legal to breed dogs that are not fit for breeding or who may be blind and have mammary tumours. There is nothing in the code that compels farmers to health test their dogs. It is legal to provide dogs with a plank of wood to sleep on, as long as that plank of wood is raised off the ground. They are not provided with any warm bedding, and this is legal, and this is government-sanctioned cruelty. Last month, the little dog was rescued from a puppy factory. She was 10 years old, and she had a belly full of dead puppies. This puppy farm is registered with council. It is also a proud member of the Pet Industry Association of Australia. That same industry that the government listened to when developing legislation. The same industry that has a vested interest in keeping puppy factories going. The government needs to listen to the groups represented here today who are on the front line of rescue and stop taking advice from this vile industry that views our best friends as breeding machines. Yeah! The Gippsland puppy farm we exposed over a year ago was a legal puppy farm. It had its permit revoked over 12 months ago and the farmer was put on a two-year good behaviour bond. It's now operating as an illegal puppy farm with 100 dogs in the shed, and for 12 months the government promised everything and delivered nothing. This is one of the rogue illegal puppy farms that they're talking about shutting down. Nothing has happened to these 100 dogs who continue to breed today. Last week I stood in a shed with 200 dogs and witnessed their suffering. For 20 years I have witnessed unspeakable cruelty. I have made a promise to these dogs that I'll not turn my back and walk away. I will remain in those sheds with those dogs until puppy factories are abolished, and I am in that shed today.
Our time is now 10. We want to see some action and we want to see it now. Plenty of people here today have let you know we're pretty angry and there's not a lot that you can have to do to get this done. Shame on anyone in politics for not getting behind.
Dream that you dare to, oh why?